Welcome to the revision class of Excel Academy. In this video, we'll be looking at the concept called as marginal relief. So what is marginal relief? Marginal relief is applicable only in cases where surcharge is applicable or attracted towards the income of the assessee. So in the previous video, we have already discussed and seen that when is the surcharge imposed and how it is calculated. So we have seen that for an individual assessee, if the income of the assessee has exceeded by 50 lakhs or 1 crore, then the surcharge is applicable. If the income of the assessee has exceeded by 50 lakhs, the surcharge which is applicable is 10%, provided it has exceeded by 50, but it has not exceeded 1 crore. Whereas if it exceeds 1 crore, then the surcharge which is applicable would be 15%. So once again, what is surcharge? Surcharge in brief is nothing but tax on tax. So now the tax on tax, if it exceeds 50 but less than 1 crore is 10%, but if it exceeds 1 crore it is 15%. This is the additional tax on top of the slab rate tax which they pay. Now let us consider one illustration for the calculation of marginal relief. So what is marginal relief then? It is nothing but the relief given to those assessees whose income exceeds marginally above the surcharge limit. So what is the surcharge limit in this case? 1 crore. So what is the income of this assessee whose case we have now just now taken up? It is 1 crore 1 lakh 50 thousand. So by how much has the assessee's income exceeded such marginal relief limit? It has exceeded only by 1 lakh 50 thousand. Just because it has exceeded by 1 lakh 50 thousand, the assessee is now supposed to pay extra tax. We will see how. So first of all, what we have to do is we'll have to consider assessee's income and calculate the tax as if marginal relief is not applicable. So let us calculate the slab rate tax first of all. So now 1 crore 1 lakh 50 thousand, we will assume an assessee whose age is, let's say, 35 years. So in this case, what can we do? First, 0 to 2 lakh 50 thousand, so there is nil tax, so since it comes under the basic exemption slab. Then comes 2 lakh 50 thousand to rupees 5 lakh. In this case, we'll have to calculate tax on the 2 lakh 50 thousand at the rate of 5%, which comes to 12,500 rupees. Then comes the next slab, which is 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs. In this case, the tax would be 5 lakhs into 20%, which is 1 lakh. So now that we have calculated the tax up to 10 lakhs, the total of the income tax liability so far would be 1,12,500. For the remaining amount, the tax rate which is applicable is 30%. So 1 crore 1,50,000 minus 10 lakhs. Okay, so this would be 91,50,000. On this 91,50,000, we are supposed to calculate 30%, which will give us 27,45,000. So this is the tax liability for the income exceeding 10 lakhs. Now all this put together, the total tax liability of the assessee would be 27,45,000 plus 1,12,500. So both put together, now it would be nothing but 28,57,500. Mind you, this is before surcharge. Now we know that since the assessee income has marginally exceeded the surcharge limit, so we'll have to still calculate surcharge. So at the rate of 15%. So if you calculate 15% on this, you will get how much? If you do the simple math on that, it would be 4,28,625. So that is 15% on 28,57,500. So if we add both, what we will get is total tax liability including surcharge, that would be 32,86,125. So this is the tax liability of the assessee whose income is 1 crore 1 lakh 50 thousand. So this is with surcharge. Now we have not gone towards cess because we know for a fact that the assessee's income has marginally exceeded the surcharge limit. So therefore, now what we'll do is we'll try and calculate marginal relief if applicable. So how do we calculate marginal relief in this case? So now what we have to do is we'll have to calculate the tax liability of the assessee once again as if the income has not exceeded the surcharge limit of 1 crore. So we'll now calculate tax liability for 1 crore. So again 0 to 250 it will be nil, and 250 to 5 lakh it will be 12,500. Then 5 lakh to 10 lakh it will be 1 lakh. This won't change anyway, it will be 1,12,500. Now let us calculate for the rest of the 90 lakhs. On 90 lakhs, if you calculate 30%, you will get 27 lakhs. But we still know that the assessee's income exceeds the first surcharge limit, that of 50 lakhs. If it exceeds 50 lakhs, then the assessee is required to pay surcharge of 10%. So these two put together, it would be 28,12,500. On this, calculate surcharge of 10% since his income exceeds 50 lakhs, but it does not cross 1 crore. So 2,81,250. So if you add both, you'll get 30,93,750. Now to this, what we have to do is we'll have to add the income which exceeds the second surcharge limit of 1 crore. So by how much does the assessee's income exceed 1 crore? It exceeds 1 crore by 1,50,000 only. So add that, you'll get 32,43,750. So this is the tax liability as calculated under the marginal relief. Once again, how do we calculate marginal relief? What we'll do is we'll restrict the assessor's income to just 1 crore. We'll not consider the extra 1,50,000 straight away. And we'll calculate the tax liability for that 1 crore, which came to 30,93,750. After that, we'll add the income which exceeds 1 crore, which is 1,50,000. So now the total tax liability is 32,43,750 before cess. So now compare this with the tax liability before marginal relief. It was 32,86,125. If you compare both, which is less? It is the tax liability with the marginal relief, which is less. Therefore, this tax liability will be considered and not the one which is calculated before the marginal relief.